In this video, I'm going to talk about the clinical prediction rule of Puentedura to predict success of a cervical manipulation for neck pain.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Research shows that cervical and thoracic manipulations can be effective treatments for mechanical neck pain, with thoracic manipulation being the safer option as cervical might be associated with cervical artery dissection. Although bigger systematic reviews found no difference between thoracic and cervical manipulations, there is not much evidence available. One of the few RCTs of Puentedura et al. In the year 2011, however, suggests that cervical manipulation is more effective than thoracic manipulation. Given that your patient displays a low risk profile for cervical manipulation, what are predictors of success of this intervention? The same authors who found out that cervical manipulations might be more effective than thoracic manipulations, Puentedura et al., have come up with a clinical prediction rule in 2012 describing several criteria to guide your decision making. This clinical prediction rule has not been validated by any further studies, which is why we are giving it a questionable clinical value. So let's look at the four different criteria that are described by the authors to predict success with cervical manipulation. Number one, positive expectation that manipulation will help. Research shows that people are experiencing better results if they believe that a certain treatment will work. In case of the manipulation, one can imagine that the placebo effect might be quite a bit bigger. Number two, duration of symptoms of the current episode of neck pain for less than 38 days. This makes sense, knowing that manual therapy in general is less effective in the rather chronic population. On top of that, people with a rather acute onset of symptoms have a better prognosis in general. Number three, a side-to-side difference of cervical rotation range of motion of 10 degrees or greater. This item was the strongest predictor of success in the prediction rule with a positive likelihood ratio of 6.8. And number four, pain with the PA spring test of the mid-cervical spine. While manual palpation has been reported to have a low reliability, pain provocation tests are highly reliable. This item makes sense as patients who do not report pain with palpation in spinal segments may be a different subgroup of patients presenting with chronic muscular or centrally sensitized pain who have problems to accurately locate their pain. If three or more of those four items were present, the positive likelihood ratio for successful cervical manipulation was at 13.5, which is a big increase of success. In a study of Puentedura, the success rate raised from 39% to 90% if at least three items were present. When cervical manipulation is contraindicated, thoracic manipulation for neck pain can be an alternative that is described to be evenly effective. If you want to learn more about the clinical prediction rule for thoracic manipulation, click on the video right next to me. Okay, this marks the end of our video. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to give this video a thumbs up and share it if you liked it. If you want to see more of us, check us out on other social media channels. For all of our videos, including articles, statistical values, and more, have a look at our very own assessment ebook or mobile app. Links can be found in the description down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.